Okay, so it's a real pleasure for me to welcome you here to our school, the School of Mathematics, Statistics and Actuarial Science, as interim head. So today what we want to do is really to show to you our university, our school, and give you a good idea of what student life would be like here at Kent and in our school. And we would like to give you basically all the advantages of joining us here next year. Okay, and we're here throughout the day and also afterwards to answer any of the questions you have. So it's I know it's a lot to take in. There's programs and regulations of what modules and options and all the opportunities. So feel free to contact us afterwards too if there's any misunderstandings or things you'd like to clarify. Okay. So, maybe a bit about the history of the university. So, the university was established 50 years ago, and originally it was a college-based system, like the Oxford and Cambridges, where students are members of colleges and also academic staff were members of a college. However, this has changed over the years. The students are still part, so if you join here, you are becoming a member of a college. And however, staff are actually associated to schools, not to the colleges anymore. But these colleges provide lots of opportunities for you, because you'll actually be among students, not only from this school, but from other subjects as well. And there are lots of social activities arranged within the colleges. There's also support, so in that sense, it creates cohesion among the whole student body. So. As I said, the university has changed. This picture clearly shows a lack of women, but that's clearly has changed. So this is the newer picture, and there are women, many more. So Kent is definitely recognized as a really good teaching and research institute. We currently hold a TEF Gold Award, which is the highest national award one could get for actually teaching excellence in higher education. Also, we are well known for student support. So we have been, you know, for the Times Higher Education, we had these awards in 2018, 2017, and we have a really strong track record in supporting our students. Okay, so then a bit more about our school. So this morning when I drove up, I was happy because actually the sun was out, and I thought, this is great. Actually, this picture might be a true reflection today, but it's already grayed up a bit. But on a good day, and we have many of those in Kent, we actually do get the sunshine, and people can sit outside and drink a cup of coffee, and the building is absolutely lovely. So, okay, so you applied here, so you're well aware of probably our statistics, I don't know. I'm myself not British, but I have a daughter 12, so I will have to come to terms with these sort of league tables and numbers, but you're well aware of this. So yes, our school, we are ranked 24th in the Times and Sunday Times, a good university guide. This is the subject one. And we have an overall student satisfaction. This is the National Student Survey of 94% in mathematics and 92% in actuarial science, which is really good. And then as you heard on the videos, we have a really strong commitment towards equality, diversity, and inclusivity. In particular, we are one of the few schools in mathematical sciences that have a so-called Athena Swan Silver Award. And this is really an award, this is a national scheme where departments have to regularly apply to actually get this accreditation for actually setting up, making sure that students, staff are all, you know, it's in an inclusive and a diverse setting. Meaning that we do appreciate that women and minorities are underrepresented in science. And we set up activities to actually mitigate this and help promote this. In fact, we have a large number of female academic staff on our degrees. Okay, so throughout our educational activities, we have a sort of driving motto, which is engagement, enjoyment, and employment. And this sort of permeates throughout all the educational activities we do. And it reflects on the students. So here's a comment from Sean, who basically we asked a number of students to summarize in three words what they thought. And he said, challenging, enjoyable, and beneficial. So it comes pretty close to what we said. So, but, you know, this challenging part is important. Okay, so I'm sure you're aware, a degree in mathematical sciences, actuarial science, statistics, or financial mathematics is not an easy one, okay? This will require dedication and time from the students, okay? So, you know, we do have very intense programs that will really lead you to the forefront of the discipline. And this, to reach that level, you'll have to engage. There's no way about it. And to help you come to terms with all this, we actually set up an intense program with a high number of contact hours. So our courses all have 4 contact hours per week with academic staff. And initially, the core modules are supported with even extra small group tutorial hours. Okay, and then of course we have very good teachers, and these people are really expert in their field. So on the actuarial program, we have lots of qualified actuaries who have gone through the ropes, have had industrial experience, and now teach on our program. But also we have outstanding researchers, both in mathematics and statistics. Actually, this week we were told that actually one of our statisticians won the Royal Statistical Society 2020 Guy Medal Bronze Award. So this is Rachel McCree, and she's a statistician working in ecology and really looking at species and survival of species that are under threat. And her research is really groundbreaking and really pushing the boundaries, and she's been awarded this medal, which is fantastic news. So. Okay, so today you will also do a campus tour, but also a tour through our building. So we're now on the first floor, which has some mathematicians and some of our staff are located. But actually upstairs here, this is our space, okay? And you'll go and see it, and you'll see that it's empty now, but during the week it's buzzing. So the staff are in, you'll see study spaces scattered throughout the corridors. And that's where students will work among the staff. So if students have questions, they can just knock on the door of the relevant staff member and ask, or just pull him by the sleeve and say, look, last week you said, you know, and I don't understand, can you explain again? And this happens. So really, you are working among us, and there's also a dedicated study center, which is a larger space for the students also to hang out. So you'll see all of that after this presentation. Okay, and then there's also really tailored academic support. So you'll be assigned, when you come in here, an academic advisor, which is an academic who will actually look after you throughout your degree here. So you'll build a personal relation with this academic staff member who will also write CVs for you. But if you know, advises you on all academic levels. If you want to make choices of optional modules, you can discuss with this person. If you want to think about maybe changing programs or exploring other options, you can discuss with this person, okay? So this is somebody who keeps an eye on you throughout your journey here. And then, of course, studying is a difficult one. You'll see. I guess the main difference with secondary school is that you need to have a drive yourself. Okay, so it is not just spoon-fed. You create your own things too. You have to do work. We'll support you. We'll provide all the tools you need, but you'll have to do work. And this can occasionally be hard. Yes, this is a journey you go through, and sometimes it happens that you, for personal reasons, get into trouble. Or, you know, you're mentally not in the right place. So at that point, we actually have a dedicated support student support team who will pick you up and make sure everything is all, you know, you'll get the support you need to go through this difficult period. So so that's there. Okay, so that was sort of the engaging part. Of course, there's the enjoyment. So, and what do we mean by enjoyment? Well, of course, you'll have fun here. But I think part of the fun, and the main fun, should probably be in your degree. Enjoy what you do in your degree. And figure out in your time here which bit of mathematics, actuarial science, financial mathematics, whatever, or statistics, you actually like. You know, you'll see actually when you come here that these areas are much broader than you think. You know, you might have done some mathematics at secondary school, but that's a tiny, tiny fraction, absolute minute fraction of the whole spectrum of mathematics that is actually on offer. And you'll get acquainted with a huge amount here, okay? And you can find the thing you like here. So here we have Mustafa, and actually he's in finance, financial mathematics, but actually he took a statistics option in stage three, which is not, it's just an option. And he really enjoyed that, but actually figured out that he actually wanted to go more into data science after this and choose a career path there. And he really enjoyed that. So we give options for you to explore during your thing and really find the thing you really enjoy. Okay, of course there's also enjoyment outside our school. And only a couple of weeks ago I was talking to the head of sports and she was telling me that the most popular event apparently on campus now that sells out quickly is the UV light roller disco. So that's why I put this picture up. So I'm not sure if you can trust me on wheels, but there you have it. Of course, you don't have to go on wheels. During the day, there's a very nice cafe downstairs and the things outside also when the weather permits to meet up with your friends and have a cup of coffee or a bit of lunch. Then also, this is a picture of Molly Ricchetta, who is one of our BSc mathematics students, and she had a good hobby. She really liked playing violin, and she took that hobby with her here and actually got a music scholarship and won all sorts of prizes. So she was really active in the music, classical musical scene here at Kent. And so if you have a good hobby, you can take it that level further and bring it here with you. Or if you decide to go completely try something new, maybe you've never done mountaineering, you join the mountaineering society and go and try and climb a mountain. So there's all things are open here. Okay, then of course when you're engaged and you enjoy, you get results. And in the end, after that hard work, you will graduate. And that will be a massive achievement, okay? That is something to be proud of. And we celebrate that with a nice ceremony in the cathedral. And here are some of our students who graduated, and we took a photo of them throwing their hats. It was a lovely day. So, but after that, it is time to think about the future, and that's where the employment comes in. So for quite a long time, I've been here 10 years, for quite a long time, we have a really strong track record in graduate employment. So we are ranked third for graduate prospects in the Complete University Guide 2020. And according to Unistats, 100% of our students are working or in higher study 6 months after graduation. So I think that's something we're really proud of. And we have lots of activities to make sure you, when you finish here, it's not all of a sudden all everything stops. In fact, that's the start of a new journey then for you. Okay, so to do this, we already in these videos, you saw a couple of things we do. So, and I want to highlight a couple. You will hear more about actually this thing. There will be a presentation by Ian Rogers later today, who will tell you more about the career activities and some of the terms you'll see on the next slide about our career activities. So, for example, you can become a student ambassador. So this means actually we do quite a lot of outreach. And in fact, at the moment, there's in the Gulbenkian, there's a theater, there's an event running. It's called This Girl Can. And it's basically to get women into science and engineering. And some of our staff are doing activities there throughout the day, but they are assisted by our students, and these are student ambassadors. Yeah? So these students help us out when we go on outreach things, and basically learn also how to interact with the general public or with secondary school students and present mathematics in a public forum. Then you could become a peer mentor. This means that basically when you're in stage three, you can help out stage two students, or when you're in stage two, you help out stage one students. So we have, particularly before exams or so, it's useful that people who've done things already also help the others out. So staff will also, of course, help out, but this is just on top of things. And for our foundation year, you can, some of our people who have been here longer can be a foundation buddy. So then there was this video about research opportunities within the school. And these, so this was actually part of something that is run on an annual basis. So the London Mathematical Society, which is the main mathematical society in the UK, annually has summer research bursaries. So these are competitive bursaries where we have to apply to get them. So we have to provide a project and a student, and this will be a 6-week project throughout the summer. The student gets paid, and this should actually lead to some genuine research in mathematics. And over the years, we've run these things successfully. We always have a couple. So these are, I think, universities usually only get one or two awarded. So and we have been successful with these. And I had one 2 years ago, and actually we did do some work, and we actually published this in a journal for undergraduate research in mathematics, and the student is now a PhD student here. So there are opportunities for you to also engage with research, okay? All right, as I said, so there are lots of activities you will hear more about later today from Ian Roger. So we have training, so CV writing clinics, interview practices, assessment center practices, all these things will happen throughout the year and you can enjoy it. We also have what is called an employability point scheme and a careers award. So this, roughly speaking, the employability point scheme is that you engage with all these things, you earn points, and then these points can be redeemed by actually some of the career fairs actually charge students, but actually to go to them. But if you have points, we'll pay for them to go. So, and in fact, my colleague Sean, in I think next week or the week after, is taking 10 students to go to a careers event in basically financial planning. So there's a lot of financial planning firms there, and there's about 10 of our students who are interested in exploring this, and he's taking them to this fair, and that's all paid for. Okay, so we have an employability festival, a job vacancy database, etc. So I should also say we do allow people to, we encourage people to explore things. So here's a picture of Melania Nika. So she's a lecturer on the Actuel program, but she does basically the economic side of it and the finance side. And she has a degree, a PhD from LSE, and she runs the investment club. So our students are basically given fictitiously $1 million. So there's a finance firm in New York, and it actually has an educational website where you get logins, you get fictitious $1 million and start investing. And so she runs this club and gives people advice of how this actually works and the mechanics of it all and the background. So it's really good fun. We also have a statistician who runs a Python programming club. So there's all sorts of things are being set up outside the standard curriculum for students to explore. Okay, then already you've seen quite a number of our students who actually have opted in for the Year in Industry program. So I think really this is a really nice thing to do. So what is the idea? Basically, you take first 2 years here, and then you take a third year out in industry. And so we have a support team that help you find a placement. So people who engage with this get a place. That is our experience. Students who do not engage with the activities we set up, like CV writing and presentational skills, they might struggle to find a placement. But if you engage with the activities we set, our success rate is very good. And people end up in all sorts of places. And it's just very nice. It's really an interesting experience and a huge advantage when you apply for a job, because you actually can claim you've actually worked for a year in industry. And in fact, these placements come with salaries. Yeah, so there are people there who actually made good money. So really this is recommended on an experience level, but actually also in our experience is that students on this program actually do better in their degrees. So here's just to show you. So these are 3 year averages of students who were on placement and were not on placement, and what the degree classification is. So 64% actually compared to 30%. So really what happens, I think, there is that students go on a placement and somehow this extra year makes them a bit more mature, but also slightly more organized. And this shows off, this pays off, really, also for your degree classification. All right, so just a brief reminder, so you're well aware of the program you probably signed up. So here are the programs we run. So we have a mathematics BSc, an MMaths, which is a 4-year maths program, BSc mathematics and statistics, actuarial science, BSc financial maths, BSc with secondary education, and BSc in accounting and finance. All of these things also have a foundation year. So if you don't have the requirements to roll straight into any of these programs, you can do a foundation year with us that will give you access to our programs. And this, I should say, this foundation year is run by our academics. You see, it is run on this campus. You will be a member of this school. You will have access to everything, and it's taught also by our staff. So this is not outsourced. This is really part of our school. Okay, so then maybe a bit about the structure of our degrees. So just to give you an idea of the flexibility you get and the room you will get to explore things. So our stage one, that's quite rigid, because we really want to make sure that everybody has the right foundation for the degree they go into. So there will be no options there. We'll bring you all at the same level to have all the foundations ready for you to go into the next stage. So that year is a transition year. So really, you come from secondary school and you'll find that this is a really step up. It's really a step change from your secondary school mathematics. And that's why we put a lot of support to make this transition right. So we have small group tutorials. This means that the core modules among those 8, you're grouped in size of 8 students, depending a bit on the module, 8 to 10 students. And then you'll have a weekly tutorial with the academic. And this will be the same person, yes? So this is a really small group where you'll go over the material that was done for that week, go over exercises with this academic. And then some of the classes also involve you learning the softwares that are there for you to, like Maple, which is a big package to do any sort of mathematics. you want. R is the standard software to do statistics. And then we have a value program. So this particularly students get nervous before the exams. It's a bit daunting because you do all this material this year, and then in the summer term you get exams. So you can sign up for this value program. It's just to make sure that you are well prepared for your exam. So you will get extra support to prepare for the exams. And then in stage two, it becomes more mixed. So you get options there to actually start exploring the things you like, and there will be options available to you. And then you're no longer supported by these small group tutorials. There will be peer mentoring, but by that time you should know your academics and you should not be afraid to knock on their doors. All academics have office hours and are quite keen also outside office hours to meet with students. So if there's any problems, you just go and knock on the door. Okay, so if you've then opted for the placement year after your stage two, you would do that. And then if not, you would just roll into stage three. And then there's basically a load of options. So then you can, I'll show you a list. I won't go through the details. A load of options for you too. So there's a choice of up to 8 modules. You can also do a project in that final year project, which will allow you to go actually deeper into a topic you like and write a short dissertation on that. There's also a communication skill module, so you'll be then tested on sort of more how you can actually communicate mathematics in writing and in a presentation. You see, this is all part of, I think, very important, is actually a very important skill in the world, is to communicate. Okay, so really we can all sit behind books and know we're the expert, but if you can't explain what you're actually thinking or doing, then that's a bad state to be in. So it's important to learn, even to communicate abstract ideas, okay, and to be able to formulate this and be willing and open to communicate about the things you do. Okay, so then there's an MMAT, which is again, that's the stage four. So that these people are not allowed to do the project, of course, in stage three, but have to write a serious project. So this tends to be the students who want to take maths just that step further. It will just give them more time to actually look at even more advanced mathematics. And some of these people are actually thinking about doing a PhD. So if you want to enter into a PhD program in mathematical sciences or statistics, you need 4 years in the UK. So either people do a BSc and then go and do an MSc elsewhere, but most people who are serious from the beginning will just do a 4-year MMAT. Just that will give them access to the PhD programs in the UK in mathematical sciences and statistics. Okay, so that also has options. And this is a nice picture. It actually relates to my research. So it's something maybe people think of Escher, but this is actually a specific model of the hyperbolic plane. And it's a tiling of this space, which is a curved thing. But all these triangles are actually congruent. So they have the same area, but this really lies at infinity. And this the distance here, it looks finite, but actually it spreads out. So anyway, this has to do with Escher tilings, something I also like. All right, so as I said, this is just a show. I'm not even sure if you can read all this, but so stage two, there's a number of options there. So these are just the optional modules. So you will have a choice from some of these modules in your stage two if you're on the MALTS program. And then in stage three, you can see the number of options goes on, and there's a lot. So there's sort of a core set of pure maths modules, then there's a core set of more applied maths modules with, say, linear and nonlinear waves. I myself teach games and strategies, which the students really like to learn to play games properly. And but on the pure side, there's like topology is there, functions of a complex variable, metric and norm spaces, groups and representations. So there's a whole spectrum of algebra, analysis, and geometry and topology coming in. And then, so here we have. So this is a module we introduced a couple of years ago because we found that our math students, they also need to have an option to really explore something different. So they want to go into a career, and so if they've never really engaged with any of the finance or anything, they have in stage three an option to just actually explore what it is like to do mathematics in the world of finance. So this is a module that's actually run by the actuaries for the math students. So, and then people can, this is more for, I guess, people doing finance. So there's option for financial math students. And then there's lots of statistics options. So statistics and data science are really the new thing, I would say. This is really important. It's so easy nowadays to collect data, and actually smart ways of analyzing data now is really important. And this is, you know, permeating everywhere, and it's becoming more important. So there's options to, for many programs, not only on the Math Stats program. If you're on the mathematics program, you can take statistics options in stage two and in stage three. Okay, so I hope I convinced you that we offer a broad spectrum and you should be able to find your niche. So on the actuarial program, I know there are actuaries here in the audience, I would like to say this is of course a vocational degree. You're probably aware that any qualified actuary needs to pass 13 accredited exams. And in our degree, you can actually get six exemptions for these exams, and this is the maximum actually one could get at any university. So there are other universities where you can also get six, but you cannot get more than six. Okay. So we have run this program really successfully for the last 30 years, and we have the most qualified actuaries among any UK university teaching on our program. So we have 12 people who have gone through the ropes, have passed these exams, and actually have worked in industry, and can tell you all about it. So, and it shows, because they don't only, tell you the theory, they actually can also tell you what it's like to apply this in practice. And for us, the mathematicians, so I'm a mathematician, it's nice because these people bring a part of our, form part of our school, which is not normally present in the UK maths department. That you actually have people who have huge industrial experience, and these people are actually driving a lot of our employment activities. Okay.
Basically, when your application goes to